Hi everyone. In the last class, we have seen two byte-oriented stream classes like file input stream classes, file output stream classes. Both are meant for to work with files. One is meant for to read the data from the files. Another is meant for to write data over the files. What are the various kind of data we can perform, either read or write? That data can be either a text or a character or an image or an audio or video, etc. Any kind of files are supported by byte stream oriented classes. Now let us discuss the concept related to character oriented stream classes. In character stream oriented classes, it is going to support only characters or textum. This is what we have seen, the difference between byte oriented stream classes and character oriented stream classes, while explaining in the first class. Okay, fine. If you observe the hierarchy, first the superclass for all classes is object, then the subclass are reader and writer. So this reader class is meant for to read data from an input peripheral devices to Java application. Writer is a used for to write data into output devices from the Java application. Guys, I have already explained input stream reader and output stream reader. Observe here you can use input stream or file reader, output stream or file writer. Okay, I mean, we can use reader or writer. So what do you mean by reader or writer? This reader is a kind of abstract class. Similar to input stream. Writer is a kind of abstract class which is similar to file output stream. Okay. So this reader class and writer class, both are super classes for various kind of classes. But the difference between both character streams and byte streams, character streams are going to support only characters, whereas the byte streams are going to support characters as well as some other kind of files. Okay. If we see the first one, file reader. And I will also discuss the class file writer, which are used to work with. So various kind of files classes are there. So all classes are meant for specific requirements. We'll see all those. First, let us see the two kind of character oriented stream classes. One is file reader. Another one is file writer. Okay, fine. So there is a kind of Java application. Here it is a file. Whose name is like abc.txt. Here it is also a file whose name is same file, I think so. Let me take. Here it is going to perform the operation like this. If it is an image file or text file, cat file, I can use here file input stream, file output stream. For example, as I am discussing the concept of purely character oriented stream, I am thinking that it is only purely supported for only characters. Then I have to use here reader. Here I have to use writer. From where I need to read the data? From a file. So I need to make it as file reader and file writer. Okay. So what is the purpose of this file reader? Its purpose is to read characters. Or text from the file. What is the purpose of file writer? To write characters or text to the file. So how to work with how to read characters? Meaning that how to work with means you need to create object for this file reader class. So how we are going to create object? By using simply file reader class. File reader some fr equal to new file reader of abc dot vis.txt. Or another way you can be able to create with respect to file class. This is what we have seen in the previous class. File f equal to new file of object of file. abc.txt. Then file reader fr equal to new file reader of object of the corresponding file abc.txt. Okay, this is the simple thing. So this file reader is going to support various kind of methods byte oriented stream, file input stream class. Like one is a read method, another one is a read character array. Here there we have seen what is the array that we have passed here, byte array. Now here the difference is we are going to use a character array. Okay, then these are all various kind of methods. Close method, these are all the methods we are going to use. So to read single character, this is meant for to read single character. This is meant for to read array of characters. Read array of characters. This is meant for to close the current file reader. Current file reader. Okay, fine. Similarly, file writer. File writer is meant for to write the characters into the file, right? So to work with this, like the way that we need to write, we need to create object for that. So that is the reason I need to use the file class, file writer class, file writer. FR equal to new file writer of. I'm writing shortcut ma, but an example I can make is file writer of string name, or I can use the other way like this one. Here what I can write, file writer FW equal to new file writer of. I can pass the object of the file. As object of file mean that if the if specified file is not there, what will happen? If it is not exist, it is going to create new one. What about this one here? It is going to write exception. Here it is going to write exception. Guys, observe, whenever you are going to write some data to a file, you will get two options: whether I want to append the data or whether I want to overwrite the data. In the file output stream also, I have explained the same thing. While writing, I have shown the syntax whether I want to append or whether I want to overwrite. Append means I need to make it true. Override means I need to make it as false. If I didn't write, it will assume it as overwrite. The same structure, if you follow here also the syntax will work. File writer w equal to new file writer of file name comma true or false. Which one I want to pass? Okay. So this file writer contains also supports the various kind of methods. One is a write method, the same thing whereas we follow there. Int ch, some character. I want to write a single character. If I want to write a group of characters, I mean a string, I need to pass a character array. If I want to pass a string, I can pass a string. I can use the method plus method. I can use the method close method, all having same meaning. I need to pass a single character to the file. I need to pass array of characters. Here I need to pass a string. I need to flush the entire data. Like this, we are having various kind of methods. Okay, now let me show some example which is related to, which will cover both of these, file reader and file writer. Okay guys, once you understood the previous classes, it is easy for you to understood the classes which we are going to see from right now onwards. That is the reason I am not explaining the entire program in the board. So while working with input output files, you need to import the package IO package. File cap. My file name is file cap. Control S, Control V, dot Java. First, let me show example which is related to file reader. What I will do is I will create a class for file reader. File reader f equal to new file reader of, I'm going to take the file name as add.java. I hope you already know that file is exist, or else I will take age.java, which is already exist. I have read that data. I'm going to take read using read method. I have read the data, which is going to read method is always going to return in the form of ASCII values, right? It's going to read single character and it's going to read in the form of ASCII value. So that is the reason I'm going to store in the integer format. So while this integer value, while this integer value is not equal to -1, I am going to print the entire data. Why I am making it as -1? Because if end of file is occurred, it will return -1. So until I got -1, I need to repeat the process to print all the characters. That's it. That is the purpose of that. System dot out dot dot print of of, I am making, observe, I am making char of file. Why I am making char of file? Because it is going to get the values in the form of character values. I am making convert into as corresponding explicit conversion. So what I will do is I will make to the next iteration. See guys, in the previous programs I have written another way. That is one type of logic. This is another type of logic. You can write whichever you want. I can make use of it. Okay, in the previous examples what it is, first I will make checking and I will go for inner loop. Now what I will do, I will go for inner loop and then check moving. I have read the data, moved, and I have printed the data. Now let me try to print the value. Observe LSS Java C space file char dot java. Okay, Java space file. Got the data or not? Yes. The thing is, this file reader, file writer doesn't support the concept of other than characters. That's it. That is the main problem here. I have read. If I want to write, for example, I want to create, I want to show it with the other way, like by using file class, file f1 equal to new file of age.java. I can make. Java. Then what I will do, I will simply pass this object. So I will take this entire thing once again. Here I will pass the object of that file, f1. That's it. If I compile and run, you will get the same answer. So two ways you can do. You got the same thing, right? So one method is read method, which is going to read a single character, but that single character, if I am going to repeat, my entire file I am going to read. Now the another way is I can be able to read the array of characters simply. So how we are going to make read that? If you observe, sir, what I am going to do is I am going to create a character there. What I did, I have created a byte array, new char of here. I can able to pass a fixed memory size, but I don't want to waste the memory. That is the reason I am going to create a memory of fixed size. First, let me take I'm going to use like this. I don't want to use this read method, all those. That is the reason I'm making it as comments. Now I will use this one. Okay, what I will do, through this f1 object, can I able to use length keyword? What is the use of length keyword? Guys, observe, for file input stream, observe, for file input stream, we have a method called available method. For file class, we have a method called length method. Which is to find total number of characters or total number of bytes available. Okay, fine. Guys, so do you think that in Java, so this length keyword, this length method is going to return what type of data? It is going to return long data type. The length method is going to return long data type. But it is, the thing is, observe, you can observe right now. If I write like this, by using this file reader object, I'm going to read and I'm going to pass that object. For that, I'm going to print the data. Int j equal to 0, j less than. So length of the array finding means int dot length j plus plus. How dot println. I'm going to print the corresponding values. H of k. So it is mandatory to close the connection, right? I said already. Now observe, you will get an error. What is that error? Incompatible types, possible lazy conversion from long to int. The meaning is Java doesn't support the long arrays. The length method is going to return long data type. But Java doesn't support long arrays. So that is, we need to make explicit conversion. In that, we are trying to tell the compiler that even though loss data, there is no problem at all. 1 minute. Dot class expected. What I did? There is some mistake. Okay, fine. So it is like, now tell me, see, observe. You got the entire data or not? So this way, you are going to use read method, which is going to read array of characters. Now let me show file writer. How we are going to write file writer fw equal to new file writer. I can use age.java. I can use simply f dot write off. If I pass 100, what will happen? I will simply, to make it clear understandability, I will make use of like this. Successfully copy. The f dot write. Oh, 1 minute. It is fw, right? What happened? Successfully copied. If you open yard.java, it contains what data? Nothing is there. Age.java file writer fw.write. Okay, fine. So 1 minute, let me show once again, or else I will refresh. Now once again check, nothing, it is not available. So whenever you didn't get output like this, then you can use flush method. This is the advantage of flush method. See, observe now, I will try to compile, I will try to check. explicit copy, go for the drive, go for age.java. Am I get or not? Yes, that is the advantage of flush method. So it is going to flush the data. Write method is saying that to the compiler that I want to copy the data into my file. But if you want to update in the file, you have to use the method flush method. That is the method flush method. Guys, observe, if I write 100, what is the output present in the file? D. If I pass 101, what is the output present? Observe. Observe, it is going to overwrite, but it is going to having character data. So meaning that, so if you are giving the input as ASCII values, it is going to convert into corresponding characters. That's it, explicitly. If you give something like direct value, direct B, it is also make available there. B is a kind of not a variable, you need to pass a string. Now what if you show that file, it contains again D. It's a override. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a copy of CSC, which is a good branch. This is a good branch. Now once again I will compile. Don't know what's happening here. I mean, as a string, right? We need to pass. Successfully copied. You open the file, it contains CSC is a good branch. Now, what I'm going to do is in that Java is one of the languages. As course, so this should be appended to the previous data. Then what I can do, I can go for using just check, successfully copy h.java. Am I get or not? So it's a good branch in that Java is one of the language as course. If I didn't write in true, what will happen? It will override. So this is where you can use the write method. This way you can use write method. Now what I want to do is, guys, observe, you can use the another way. What is that another way? I can make comment for your understandability. You can simply use the concept of files. File f equal to new file of age.java. Here I can pass what? File object reference. Yeah. Like this also I can work. It's another way. Okay. Now, one more thing. Instead of write, I can pass as a single parameter. I can pass array of characters, but those characters should be available in the character array. So I will write like char array of or g u a b r g p t. I have created an array. This way can I create array? Yes, we can create. Now simply I can pass this array to here. Write of CX. I have explained here, write of character array I can pass. Now observe, it will be appended or it will be overridden? It will be appended. Now try to compile, try to run, successfully copied, open add.java. What happened? Course up to here the previous data, last word is RGKT. What is RGKT? Like this you can do. So finally, anyway, you have to close the file every time. Similarly, if you want to pass characters, if you want to pass the characters, you can pass. Or else, see, observe here. for example, I don't want to append so that you will get much clarity. Ch comma, I will write 0, 2. The meaning is that I have to start from the location 0th location in the array character array ch. How many characters I want to copy means 2 characters. Observe how to work all this interface. You have cannot find symbol 43. Sorry, this is FW. Successfully copied. RG. That's it, right? From 0th position, you got only 2 characters. That is the meaning of this one. 0th position, you got only 2 characters. That is R and G. If you want to pass 4 characters, you can pass. Or if you want to pass from 1, index 1 to 4, meaning that GUKT is going to copy there. Successfully copy. Open edge.java. Yes, GUKT is copied. Like that, you can use this write method. If you want to pass the string, you can pass the string also. String s equal to. S equal to Krishna. We can pass simply, or else for your explanation, I am making it a comment so that it will be easy for you to write. FW dot write off. Yes, that's it. Observe. It is going to override. It's going to override J Krishna. That's it. So like this, you can use this file writer and file reader. Okay. Now what I'm doing in the same example, I'm going to let me explain. So up to now, I have explained like in a single program, I have used only either file writer or file reader. I want to combine both in a single location, in a single code. What I will do is I'm going to read some data and I'm going to copy it into some other location. That's it. I'm going to read some data and then I'm going to copy it into some other location. Or I'm going to write some data into one location and then I'm going to read that data. Read the data. Okay. So I can use the concept of files so that before going to go for any kind of exception, it always going to provide, to not to occur an exception. If add.java exists, there is no problem. If it is not exist, what we can do is we can create that file, right? Create new file. So that we won't get any kind of exceptions. Add.java. What I will do by using file writer, I'm creating a stream. So that I can able to perform write operation over add.java file. Okay, so by calling the method write method, I can pass the string example of file writer and reader. And then I can simply flush it. You know why I am going to flush? If I am not going to flush, it is not going to update me the file. That is it. I am going to flush and I am going to close that file. In the same thing, so what I will do is to make our understandability, I will write like return successfully. Meaning that after return, we will get the message like return successfully. Now, from the same file, I am going to read the data. File reader, fr equal to new file reader. File reader of which object I need to pass on the same file, right? So that is the reason I'm going to use f. So f means it is going to point to by the add.java file. So while working with the concept of character streams, I need to use the only character array ch. new char of Sarah. Whether I want to use dynamic array or whether I want to use the fixed size. If you use dynamic array, it is helpful for you in a good manner, so that memory won't waste. So that is the reason I am using. Then I can use length method. So this I have shown already. What is the meaning of this length? So length method available in which class? File class. That is the reason I am applying over file class. Have that. Now I am going to read the data in the form of array of characters. .ch, and for our simplicity, for our understandability, I am going to print the data in the console. Int a equal to 0. A less than at array dot length a plus plus out dot println of I'm going to print the data right char of ch of a. Okay. So now let's check. Open add.java. Add.java file is there. It contains what? An example. If I run this program, what happened? It contains the example of file writer and reader statement is there, and then we will get written successfully on the console. Then we will get once again example of file writer and reader. We will get the answer. See, observe. Got written successfully. Example of file writer and reader. I'll go for add.java. Observe here what happened. Example of file writer unreader. Okay, so this is a simple example where you can use both the file reader and writer in a single program. Okay, I hope you understood it clearly of both file reader and file writer classes. Okay, fine. Thank you.